Hey guys, Kedrick's here, and I'm here with Marcus Chronicle from Greystone Chronicles, and we're going to talk about a few things on the channel today, mainly where our two channels are going to be, you know, kind of collaborating more, and some expectations for E3 and stuff like that. So what do you want to start with, collaborations?
Sure.
All right, so what I was thinking was maybe we could do, you know, more of the red versus blue reactions together, because I mean we both have different day jobs, obviously, but now I was thinking, I mean, with my day job having me away during the day most of the time, maybe we'd be able to, you know, get the reactions done on, say, Fridays, maybe even Saturdays. You don't work on most Fridays, do you?
I've worked one Friday since I started the job.
Well, Fridays are the only days that I have off besides Saturday and Sunday, so I mean there's that. So yeah, I think whenever Season 14 comes out, we might save the reactions and reviews until Fridays. Maybe. I mean, it depends. It's up in the air. We don't really know where this is going to go, but we're going to try to, you know, keep the two channels as closely together as possible, because we're trying to grow both of them.
Yeah. Doesn't help that I can't upload long videos.
Why can't you upload long videos anymore?
The strike.
Oh, right. You got a strike.
Yeah, that expires May 16th. But at that point, I'm going to be able to add a lot more stuff to the channel.
Yeah, with, what did you have the strike for again? Was it Viacom?
Yeah.
That was for review purposes, right?
Yep.
Well, that's under fair rights. I can't do that.
Yeah.
That's under fair rights. And I remember in one of your reviews, they copyrighted your own art thing.
Yeah, that was the first one.
Right, right.
I'm still angry about that.
Well, they can't do that. Because it was your art. It was yours. You created it, and they're claiming copyright on it when, you know, it's clearly yours. You clearly made it.
They actually claim copyright on both my videos. Because I uploaded the first one to my other channel, and the second one they copyrighted on Graceland Chronicles. So
I mean, I don't really get it, really. I mean, if it's under, did you, like, put out a dispute?
Yep.
And you said that it was clearly under fair use as it was in review purposes.
That's right.
Well, then, I again, where's the fair use? I mean, it's like, I don't know, content creators are just getting slammed all over the place. But back to our channels interlocking. Or collaborating more. I think it's taking too much effect already. Anyway, oh, what was I about to say? I don't even remember. Anyway,
probably
so
Ruby.
maybe. So I was thinking gameplays, where you have a lot of gameplay stuff on your channel. You know, we might be able to start doing some collaborations, like maybe a versus sort of deal between the two channels. We play competitive games and stuff like that. We've talked about that in the past.
We probably have a lot of games.
The only PS4 games that I have that I think we would be able to go up against each other on are, we got Call of Duty, One Piece,
J-Stars.
J-Stars Victory, and Naruto. And we've got a few Xbox games. We got 360. We've got that UFC fighting game. Got Halo games. Like, we got all the Halo games. I do, at least.
Yeah.
Is Fallout 4 multiplayer?
No.
No.
I wish it was. That would be fun.
Destiny. Destiny is multiplayer. If there's a
Destiny, we would have to have more than two people. A minimum of six in order to make it a constant. We're able to fight each other.
Really?
Yeah. Unless if they added a four-player mode or a two-player, I don't know. I don't pay much attention to the Crucible.
It's like Crucible's pretty fun though. When you've got that kill streak going, it's fun. It's fun.
Yeah.
And I think we might be starting up a Twitch at some point. What are we gonna call that? Kedricks and Greystone?
Probably not. We could just call it Kedricks Marcus. Or we'll figure it out.
Kedrick's Chronicle? Kedrick/Chronicle? I don't know.
Leave suggestions in the comments.
Yeah, leave suggestions in the comments. As well as versus games that you'd like to see the two of us go up against. Odds are Naruto games, I have the upper hand on Naruto games. Shooter games, we're kind of even on that one.
It depends on the shooter game.
Yeah. Like, Halo is something that we're kind of even on, I guess. Like, well, if you were to put us both in Halo Reach on, say, custom maps, like, say, one that I designed and one that he designed, odds are he'd win on the one he designed, I'd win on the one I designed. So, I mean, I think maybe sort of doing it, like, on, say, Halo Reach, we did a half and half. You know, I did one half of custom world and you did the other half. And I guess, you know, we just see how many kills we can get. I don't think it'd be as fun, though, with just the two of us. I think we need to find a way to get more people into it.
Well, we got Ninja, was it?
And he doesn't... Ninja Storm 93 doesn't have an Xbox anymore. Yep. He sold it so he could get his PS4.
I respect that.
Yeah, well, he also got that GameStop credit card and was in debt for a few months.
Well...
I can't say anything about that, though, because I was stupid enough to do it, too. Although, I'm out of it. I got out of it very quickly. Like, within 2 weeks. Yeah. So, I mean, it's different in his position and in my position. It's just different. Regarding other people, NinjaStorm93, I'm going to try to talk him into doing the YouTube stuff as well, because I don't know if he'd have anything actually good, but... I mean, I'd be interested to see where it all went. And regarding Ruby, that seems to be a very hated subject on my own channel. It's like people either just don't like Ruby or don't like me reacting to Ruby. And I don't know what it is, really.
I haven't paying attention to your videos. I haven't had time.
I know. You don't pay attention. But I thought I told you about that. Like,
yeah, I know.
I don't know how... There was this one video. Remember the first video we ever did? We got that mean comment. It's just like... The dude was just automatically all up on top of us. Like, you bunch of... He's just calling us the worst reviewers. Saying we suck. All that stuff. You know, I actually... That's... The only comment I've ever actually deleted because, you know, it's I'm not sure if it was a hater or a troll. Doesn't matter. But so many people just hate the Ruby reactions and reviews. I don't know if it's because I'm not enthusiastic enough, but I think with you on there, I might actually get somewhere better, I guess. I don't know.
Who knows?
And I think it could help out your channel. I think, also, I got to get you that Cards of Humanity. We've done some Cards Against Humanity sort of plays. Like,
yeah, you still have both those files.
Yeah, I do. I think they're on my hard drive, actually. I'll have to look for them. It won't be hard, though. The two largest files, they lasted over hours.
Yeah.
That's like an hour and a half for the first time we ever played. And how many of us was that? Was that? It was four of us, right?
It was four of us the second time, three of us the first time.
No, it was four of us the first time. There was you, me, Neon, and Ken.
Neon wasn't there.
Huh?
Neon wasn't there.
Yeah, you were.
Neon.
And who was it?
It was just you, me, and Ken.
I could have sworn
Neon was going to show up, but...
Right. I forgot. Oh. Right, it was during the second one that we actually had someone not facing the camera.
I noticed throughout at the second half that you and Neon both ended up off camera when it was just me and Ninja.
Yeah, because I was trying to make sure everyone got in the shot as much as possible. And it's not easy to do when, you know, it's a small room. So,
yeah.
I mean, getting that many people in here at once... Trial enough as it is, because my mattress right here was just in the way.
Yeah.
And, you know, we had to make enough room for the table and everything, and it was just, wow. Wow. Anyway, moving on to other stuff. Let's talk about our expectations for E3. What I am hoping for most when Square Enix is rumored to have an E3 conference again this year, which was incredible last year, because we got the final... Actually, that was a... on the PlayStation Day on Tuesdays, PlayStation had the Final Fantasy VII remake trailer, and everyone went nuts for that.
Can I just say, I'm still annoyed that it's going to be episodic.
Oh, yeah. That's... It's like, we already know what happens in the game, but I guess it's just going to be so big that, you know...
I expect...
Like, if it's so big now that we don't have to worry about whether or not we can catch up on it, like, we're going to be so tremendously packed with, like, say, new content, like, tougher bosses and all that, like, some extra stuff in there.
Well, what I expect for the game is the first episode will be the entire first disc, and it'll do that for the second and the third, and I hope we get the fourth disc that was on the computer remake but never was on the console.
What was on the fourth disc?
I have no clue. I'm thinking it's Advent Children.
I don't know. I mean, that would be 2 years after the events of Final Fantasy VII. You know, I've gotten to the final boss fight, but it just took me so long that I was just like, you know what? I give up. I can't take it anymore. I'm so bored.
I'm still there, but I'm trying to get the Master Materia on my file, which is not fun.
E3. Alright, so we already got Final Fantasy 15's release dates for September 30th. So my Final Fantasy stuff is, all I really want now is either another trailer for Final Fantasy 7 or the release window. Like, you know, coming 2017, because I believe we know that 15 is coming worldwide.
Yeah.
So, I'm personally excited for that. The demo was okay. It wasn't great. I personally like the Duskade episode. Have you actually played it?
No, I got it downloaded. I think it's either still downloading the last hour or it's done.
The Platinum demo?
Yeah.
Oh, no. I was talking about the Duskade episode. I wondered if you ever played it on my PS4 before you got yours.
No.
Yeah, because you could only get it by pre-ordering Type O. Which was probably a good game on the PSP, but on the PS4, I'll say it right now, it wasn't worth it. Personally, what I'm hoping for most is a new Kingdom Hearts trailer, and I honestly don't know if I want it for 2.8 or 3. Actually, I want it for both, but if I had to pick one over the other, I think I would have to pick Kingdom Hearts 2.8 with a release date. And if not that, Kingdom Hearts 3 with a release year. Like, I can just imagine it. I see Kingdom Hearts coming 2017, and if it said worldwide underneath that, I would flip. Like, I would just lose my absolute mind. The idea just kind of brings tears to my eyes.
Well, I kind of hope they troll everyone again, because I saw the best reaction when Kingdom Hearts Unchained Key was announced last year.
What do you mean?
Someone, I was watching
Josh Scorcher. When they showed the Unchained Key trailer right before Kingdom Hearts 3, and everyone was just like, oh, it's just Unchained Key. And then they saw 3, and they're like, yeah!
Well, here's the thing. You saw Key, and he had a letdown, but he lost his mind. He screamed probably for about 20 seconds.
I know I screamed. I was so unbelievably hyped. Most recent Kingdom Hearts 3 trailer we had, it was good. Don't get me wrong. I loved having the new content and everything. But I would personally like a little bit more of a story trailer.
I don't remember the last trailer.
No.
Was it the E3 one?
No. It was the one we got on for the D3 Anaheim back in November.
Yeah, I don't remember that.
How do you not remember? It showed us the... what was it called? Star Blaster? No, not Star Blaster. That sort of Toy Story looking ride, the Buzz Lightyear thing, at Yensid's Tower.
Yeah, I just don't remember.
Did you see the 2.8 trailer?
I have to go and watch these.
We got to see. We got to see Riku, Kairi, and Mickey as well as Yensid in the Unreal Engine 4.
I completely missed that trailer.
How did you miss that trailer?
I have not had... That was around when I had my last phone, and I had no internet on that thing.
And I missed that trailer? Oh, man.
Well, at least I know what's going up on my channel next.
Yeah, he reacts to that cool trailer. I guess I kind of spoiled it for you by saying there's no story in it.
So?
I mean, that's what I'm a little disappointed about, because I forget what it was. I think that there was this... D23 back in August, where they announced Big Hero 6 or something like that.
Yeah, they announced Big Hero 6 and
They had a special trailer for Kingdom Hearts 3, and it's only been seen there, and it had Ventus and Roxas in it, which I want to see that trailer so bad. It was like Ventus and Roxas. We know that they're coming back now, and it was said to be a very emotional trailer as well.
We knew Ventus was going to show up.
Regardless. Ventus has got to show up.
Roxas was just someone we wanted to see, but had no reason to believe.
Roxas has to show up.
You
and good. Shion better show. Shion is my favorite out of all the female characters. Well,
the two people now that I know that we don't know if they're showing up now that I want to see, Shion and Venus. I still want to see them show up.
You want to see them hook up is what you want. I'm in that group. You can tell I'm a Venus fan because I'm wearing the Unverse logo on my YouTube channel's shirt. And by the way, he's making me a logo, which I actually don't remember what it looks like. I remember it has the Unverse logo in it, but
that was one of them. I made a few designs.
Made more? You made more?
They were on the same thing. I don't remember where I put that.
Find them and let me see them, because I'm gonna want to put one of them on this channel, because, you know, I want to get a shirt made that's with my own custom logo, or, you know, try not to put anything that's too relatable to Kingdom Hearts or anything like that.
Yeah.
I mean, heck, if I could, I could probably do my own drawing for a character and, do that. It'd have to be one of those black and white. I could do a manga-style shirt. I mean, I got that Naruto shirt recently, and it was monochromatic. Like, the only thing it had in there, aside from black and white and gray, was red. And, like, the only colors I wear are black and red anymore. It's like, I rarely wear anything else.
That's because it's the best color combination.
Well, I'm out. So, expectations for E3. I really, really want to see Kingdom Hearts. And, like I said, if I want to see anything regarding Kingdom Hearts, it's a release date for 2.8 or a release year for 3. And I want to see worldwide under either one of them, because if I see worldwide under either one of them, I'm going to flip out, because it's... Wow. And in other news, we've started playing Kingdom Hearts Key, Unchained Key.
But yeah.
It took me forever to download. I actually tried to download it on my phone for a good, like, 15 hours.
I got about 10 minutes before you did.
ten minutes before I did. But I've been downloading it on my phone for pretty much all day, about 12 hours straight. At last, I just finally caved in and said, you know what? I'm gonna go get me a tablet. So now I've got a tablet.
You want to show that off for them?
Show it off? No. But I just straight up went, got a tablet just so I could play Kingdom Hearts Key. I can actually play it on my TV.
Yeah.
Like, it's got that, you know, cast screen thing. Although, it's hard to do because, you know, you got to look at the screen in front of you, but then you got the big one up there. I think that'll be good, like, if someone wants to see what you're doing. You could be looking at the screen like this, and they're just like, dude, take out that Heartless.
I mean, as a multiplayer Let's Play, because you can form parties, if you could record just your screen, everyone could be in here and actually be doing things.
I've been trying to. I tried to do a party with NinjaStorm93 last night, and we were both in a party. We were both under the Leopardus. I was under Unicornus at first, but I switched over to Leopardus, and because... Yeah, I just figured, you know, why not? He's my best friend. Form a party. I think that's kind of crap that you can't be in different unions and form a party.
Then we'll never be in a party because I took
Serpentis?
No, Vulpes.
Vulpes. Oh, the fox one.
Yeah.
I was like, because there was Vulpes, and then there was Ursus, and then there's Angus. Angus, I think that's what it's called. That snake one always loses me. It's like, I don't know what its name is.
I didn't even bother looking at the snake one once I read Unicornus.
Oh, Unicornus is awesome.
Well, I just read that title to start.
Look at his Keyblade and you'll think, wow.
I don't bet the Keyblade isn't cool. The name is stupid.
Yes, it's Unicornus, but dude, he's. Have you seen the theory that he's that Riku is actually the reincarnation of Unicornus?
I don't pay attention to theories. They aren't that.
Theories make you think, man. I mean, you've heard some of my theories.
Yeah.
We've been going on. I think I know what to call this. We call this the Kedricks and Marcus talk hour.
Yeah.
It's like, let's see how long we can go before.
This will be the trial run of our podcast series.
Yeah, the Kedricks and Greystone Chronicles podcast. Kingdom Hearts Unchained Key. I mean, we tried to form a party, and we both went on to the same mission, but we were nowhere near each other. We weren't in the boss raids. I don't know if we did anything wrong. We're both party members. We're both administrators, actually. And if you were, Lepardus as well, I mean, there's a theory that the five masters are the original, like, their reincarnations are Riku, Terra, Aqua, Kairi, and Ventus. Ventus being Lepardus, Riku being...
aren't there six masters?
The sixth master is a rumor. It's never been officially confirmed, I don't think. Because we've always thought, maybe there's a sixth master, maybe he's the traitor. But if... I know you don't watch the theories, but there's a theory that HMK came up with that Ventus is a reincarnation of Lepardus, and that's why Xehanort chose Ventus to be the Keyblade, because Lepardus may have been the actual traitor. Hmm. And he thought that, if Ventus is in fact the reincarnation, then he would betray as well. He'd start the second Keyblade War. And if you listen to HMK's review on it, he'll actually tell you that the voice actors for each of the characters, Ursus sounds like Terra, Unicornus sounds like Riku, Vulpes sounds like Kairi, Lepardus sounds like Ventus. In fact, these characters actually have the same hairstyles, hair colors as well. And Agnes, or whatever it's called, Agnius, sounds and has the same hair color as Aqua. Like, you've really got to look up close to them. And even, their heights sort of match, as well as their builds and even fighting styles to an extent. HMK set up that theory, and I'm just relaying what I remember from it. But, Unchained Key is a fun game, don't get me wrong. I do not like that there are some things that you can't do, it's not a hard game to do or to play. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. I'm just blabbering on at this point. Honestly, I like the fact that we can get older Keyblades. Like, I'm currently in Wonderland. Or no, I'm in Agrabah. I'm in Agrabah, and I've got the Lady Luck Keyblade. And, I like that certain attacks can defeat certain Heartless. It's not the same kind of gameplay that we're used to. I'm so used to the button mashing.
Well, it's kind of a more realized version of Chain of Memories.
Yeah, I mean the medals are much cooler. Each of them has that, unique ability.
It requires strategy, but I haven't quite figured out what strategy entirely. I just know the obvious red defeats green defeats blue defeats red.
Yeah. Power beats agility, agility beats magic, and magic beats strength. And I think that's what they're called, because I didn't figure that out until I was like five or six missions in.
Yeah. I was wondering what it was, because I just noticed it on like third mission in the bottom right corner.
You got your new rock, paper, scissors.
Well, I looked at that and I was like, what does this do? Nothing.
Yeah. Okay. I like that they sort of put that there, because it makes you have to think strategically. Right now, where we're at the beginning of the game, we've only got three commands that we can use, plus the one friend command. And that's actually kind of difficult to do because, you know, we know what the boss is going to be like. We know what kind of abilities he's going to have, but then there's going to be all the little minions just rolling around, and I go out, I kill everything.
Yeah, same.
It's like, I've gone for the hardcore style, and I've gone for all that, and, you know, that's just the way that I roll, but it's like, you got to figure out how to optimize, especially when you're at this form and stage, and then it comes down to if the boss has, you know, that one set ability, you got to figure out, okay, what am I going to use against him? And then if you, like, focus everything on just one specific attack, like, you focus it all on magic because it's a power type, and you run into a speed type.
I actually don't have much trouble with that.
It's like, well, technically, you would be screwed because, I mean, if you're trying to win during the first one, it isn't, the enemies aren't hard.
Yeah, it's very rare when I don't win during the first turn.
Oh, yeah. I mean, same. Especially with that spinning move. That is helpful. That spinning move where you just do that and Keyblade Wielder just spins around.
I think the most useful character I've used so far is Goofy.
Because the funny part is that he's one of the most powerful characters in my metal collection.
It's Goofy and Valor Form Sora.
Oh, I hate you. I want Valor Form Sora.
Yeah, I just got it randomly when I got Bambi.
I've got Kingdom Hearts 2 Sora. He's a speed type.
Yeah.
Mickey is my most powerful of the magic types, and Goofy is my most powerful and my only power type.
Really?
Yeah, I can't get any more red metals.
Green is the one I run into the least. Red is the second least. I got a ton of Mickeys.
I run into the blue more than any other.
Yeah, the blue is very easy to get.
It's like, blue. I'm like, I know I love blue team on red versus blue, but give me the red.
I don't remember. My Sora is either green or red. I think he's red.
Have you been doing the Avatar stuff?
Yeah. Got a few of them.
Yeah, I've unlocked Sora's Kingdom Hearts 1 outfit as well as the hair.
I got the 3D outfit.
I've got that one too. I just haven't unlocked the full board yet. Like, I'm almost done with it.
Yeah, I'm missing two, I think.
Yeah.
No, that's a hairstyle.
The hairstyle is actually in Sora's Kingdom Hearts 1 outfit.
Not that one. A different hairstyle I got.
Oh, the ponytail thing?
No. No. It's one you get after that. Whatever it is.
I don't remember. I got, when I did Sora's Kingdom Hearts 1 outfit, I got Sora's spiky hair, and I just went with black spiky hair. Now I'm basically blue-eyed Vanitas.
I will say this. What I love about the game is my character, without doing anything, already has my personality.
How so?
Just when I was dealing with Doc, the more he talked, the more annoyed I got. And then I just started noticing,
oh, yeah,
my character's getting really angry.
Not really angry, just kind of, just like,
yeah,
just annoyed or something. Doc, I get it, that's his trait. He has this stuttering problem, or, you know, mispronouncing words, confusing them all up problem. It's like, mustn't be so trusting. I can't even do it on purpose. It's like, you heard me, I immediately said, you mustn't, and I was like, no, you mustn't, you trustn't. I can't do it on purpose. It'd take me about 6 or 7 takes before I finally got it without laughing.
I know how annoying speech problems can be, having a speech impediment, but that drove me insane.
Oh, yeah.
Just to read.
So I used to have a, when I was, I think I was like 6, that's when I had a speech impediment. I got out of it pretty quickly, though. I got lucky. I forgot what I was about to say.
Something about Doc. I got to the point with Doc where I just started skipping the second line he said. I would read the first part, skip the second part to, and then whatever he was trying to say.
It's like, I kind of wish that this had voice acting. The only voice acting that we've had so far is Kyrie's grandmother, and
I kind of find that funny, actually.
Because she was the only character in Kingdom Hearts 1, aside from young Sora and Riku and Kairi, that didn't that was not audible.
Yeah, she was the only character in the game that no point was ever had voice acting.
Not even in a different form. It's like Sora and Kairi and Riku, you know. But even teenage Riku in the final mix, he lost his audio. Even the king did. And I don't get why Final Mix didn't have that audio in there, unless, you know, it was just just rehashed clips, because a lot of the stuff that was said was recorded already, so it was pretty much just, you know, copy and paste.
Well, I think that is it. Just they already had the audio files, I believe, because I don't think they redid any of the cutscenes.
That's what I said.
So
obviously they couldn't do it with 1.5 because Haley Joel Osment, he's older now and he's got that deeper voice. I actually saw this one comment once in a Kingdom Hearts video. It said, "It's too bad Sora isn't being played by Haley Joel Osment anymore." I'm like, it's like, dude, did you read the cut? Did you read the credits?
I'm going to say no, because I never do.
I mean, I have, with, like, cast and crew. I've read the cast.
Like, I wouldn't be surprised if you memorize it, considering how much Beacon wants to.
I only know a handful of the actual voice actors, though, that play in Kingdom Hearts 2. I know David Gallagher, Hayden Panettiere, obviously Haley Joel Osment, Jesse McCartney, Brittany Snow is, nominate. Quentin Flynn has become sort of a giant in voice acting, especially with Axel and even Reno in Final Fantasy VII. I forgot what I was about to say. I know that, what's his name? The guy who played Eric in Boy Meets World and also played Terry McGinnis in Batman Beyond, he played Cypher, actually.
Huh.
Batman Beyond was Cypher, the enormous douchebag that I only lost to once just to figure out what would happen during the tutorial. Like, you know, when you're in the sand lot and he's just like, "Neil, loser." I'm like, what would happen if I actually lost?
I actually found out there's the day after the Struggles tournament, you can still fight him.
I know. I mean, he's, even during the Struggle tournament,
well, yeah,
you can still fight him. You just gotta keep going in and out of the back alley. I'm like, why does this keep happening? It's like, why can't he just be back to where he was a second ago? And be like, you know, hey, let's have a rematch, because you just got lucky. It was like, that would be so easy.
I actually didn't know about either time until I was playing Final Mix, because I never went back into the alley. I just went through the Struggle tournament.
Remember that one time where I actually played Kingdom Hearts 1 all the way through, except I skipped Monstro, and I went straight up to the point where you beat Ansem Possessed Riku? Like, you know, with the...
Yeah, you went back and you had a different cutscene?
Yeah, it was a different cutscene. I was surprised. Square Enix actually thought ahead. They were like, what if someone actually skips Monstro altogether, doesn't even get the high jump.
It wouldn't be the first time.
True, I mean, the first time I played through it, I skipped through Monstro and went straight to Neverland, but, I mean, I don't think anyone's actually, like, openly said this. Like, you know, there's another cutscene.
Yeah, I went online to see if I could find it. I could not find it anywhere.
I don't think anyone's done it, and it's such a pain to do. But I think I might actually do it just to, I think I'll just do, like, a speed run, like, work my way through it, and...
Well, it doesn't take that long.
Well, I mean, it depends. I'll probably, like, replay it on beginner mode, and when I get to, that point where, you know, I'm at a high enough level and everything, I'll go fight Riku, because...
Let me tell you something. Playing beginner mode on Final Mix is literally you walking up to everyone and saying, "Hey, you're dead now." I'm not joking.
I have not played it on beginner mode ever.
I did, because I just wanted to do the quick no die, no death run.
Oh, yeah. I mean, well, I did it for that. I did it for the trophy. I did it for the no death. And, oh, man, there was this one time I was at that final stage right before the final rest. And I was this close to dying. Like, you have no clue I was that close. Had I not healed, I would have just lost completely.
I thought you were going to say something completely insane, like Goofy was finally helpful. No.
Donald.
Yeah.
Donald actually was the one who healed me.
He was finally helpful.
He's like, I know you want that trophy, and we didn't save after beating Chernabog. I have a horrible Donald impersonation. I don't care.
Then again, the Chernabog drives me insane. I hated
the Chernabog as a kid. I was 9 years old the first time I ever fought that thing, and I was 9 years old, and it scared the living crap out of me.
I don't ever remember being scared of it. I just remember dying to it constantly.
I was scared of it the first time. I mean, you know, I didn't know what it was. The music was somewhat terrifying to a 9 year old. Yeah. And honestly, it's because of Kingdom Hearts 1 that the only games that can scare me are games that have those jump scares that I'm not expecting.
I don't really get scared at jump scares. I don't know.
You haven't played Arkham Knight yet. There are jump scares in there. And, dude, I was not expecting Man-Bat to show up at all. Like, it's like I'm grappling up to a building, then suddenly...
There is one time I was playing Fallout 4, and something they did with Fallout 4 that they didn't do with any of the others was they gave the Deathclaw, the biggest, strongest enemy in the game, its own kill cam. Meaning, if it grabs you, it can eat you. And you get to watch it in first person.
You get to watch yourself be eaten?
Kind of. Well, it kind of just bites you and you're dead, but...
Oh, man.
Like, it can throw you far. They were not messing around with Deathclaws in that game.
So, oh, man. But no, Arkham Knight had some serious jump scares. Like, alright, I was on the verge of platinuming. Actually, I had just platinumed Arkham Knight on Halloween, of all days. The very night that the game takes place. I platinumed it on Halloween in 2015. And I'm like going throughout all the different buildings. I'm just enjoying a good time. And suddenly, Man-Bat. And the controller went flying out of my hand. I'm like, whoa! And, you know, I didn't scream like, holy... or anything like that, but I was scared. Like, it just, I was not expecting it. And I was like, wait, I already put Man-Bat in jail, what's going on? I actually went all the way back to the precinct where you have him locked up, and he's gone. Like, everything's, like, the cage that was holding him is destroyed. I'm like, what? It's like, was this supposed to happen? I looked it up. It's actually an event that they had planned. It's that on Halloween, Man-Bat would break out. It's like, they had it planned the entire time. I knew nothing about it, and it scared the crap out of me. I was not expecting it. I really wasn't.
Let's do this. I know a lot of people got freaked out in, Arkham Asylum when Scarecrow's gas made you think, oh, the game froze and the blue screened or whatever it was. Just, I saw that.
Oh, when it reset.
Yeah, I saw that and I was like, yeah, no, I don't believe it.
It's like it reset all the way to the very beginning, and it was a madhouse game at that point. It's like Joker's about to shoot you in the head and said, move the middle analog stick. And then it says, you died, try again. And I'm just like, wait, what? It was so confusing. It was maddening. I didn't know what was going on.
Yeah, I had no clue what was going on. I was just like,
what happened?
It wasn't even like it was weird. It was just like, oh, Scarecrow.
Yeah.
That was it.
Yeah. I think Scarecrow did such a better job in Arkham Knight because I love the design for Scarecrow in Arkham Knight. I mean, so much more than the one from Asylum. Because, well, for one, it looks at least a little bit scary.
Yeah,
if someone actually came up to me looking like that with like syringes in his hands, going all Freddy Krueger style on me. I'd be scared. I'll admit it. I'd be scared. I'd be running away and everything. And the voice actor that they got for him did an absolutely great job. Concerning video games, I think that they're getting a lot more story bases nowadays, and that's actually pretty good, because it's like, I mean, Kingdom Hearts has one of the best stories for a video game I've ever seen. And I played a lot of video games, that's saying something. First-person shooter games don't really have the best of stories, usually.
Yeah.
Because there's the campaign modes for Call of Duty, and I mean, they're not bad, but I don't think they really grab the attention that, you know, people are wanting from it. In fact, most first-person shooter games don't focus as much on the story. They focus more on stuff like, you know, the multiplayer aspects nowadays. It's not even about the story anymore. Especially since I beat Halo 5 in, like, 6 hours.
I still haven't played Halo 5. It's not been worth it to me. I couldn't even beat Halo 4 on my own. I did not have an interest. If I didn't play with Neon, I probably wouldn't have ever been in it.
It took me a while to beat it, mainly because of that flying mission. That was the worst mission ever. I was so glad that they didn't throw anything else like that in Halo 5.
Oh, that one. Yeah, I had that one.
The spaceship thing. I mean, the spaceship was okay in Halo Reach. I mean, it was open space. It was open space. You know, you weren't trying to avoid certain obstacles. And if you got hit, you didn't have to go all the way back to the very beginning of the level.
Yeah.
Just went back to the last checkpoint. And with Halo 4, there was that one level. It was like, you're almost at the end. You're almost at the end. You screwed up one time. Now you're all the way back at the beginning. And you screw up about 7 more times before you can even get past the second block.
I find it funny. When we were playing, we had stops after finishing the level right before it. Came back a week later, started playing, had no idea what was going on. We had no clue.
Yeah, Halo 5 was kind of disappointing in a way, because we didn't get to see Master Chief for more than 3 levels. 3 levels with Master Chief, and the other 12 with Spartan Locke. And for some of those missions, there wasn't any actual fighting. It was just walking around and talking I'm serious. Just walking around talking to a few other characters. And that was the end of the mission. It was honestly pointless.
Best action game ever. Don't you love having a gun not being able to shoot it?
Regarding Halo, I wonder if they're going to use Season 14 for Halo 5. Because, I mean, if they're introducing a new character, they're obviously going to introduce a new character with Project Freelancer, half of Season 14. Because, I mean, it's pretty clear that they're going to do, what they did in Seasons 9 and 10.
Who knows? Maybe we'll get to know what did they say about the flashbacks? Just said that was going to be the big thing.
They said that this was going to be a backstory sort of deal, but we already know everything about the Reds and Blues. We know how they met. We know how they've interacted with each other over the years. But since we heard, Wyoming and he's dead, we heard York and he's dead, we heard South Dakota and she's definitely dead. Because Wash made sure she was dead. She's my most hated Red vs. Blue character. I think that they're going to do exactly what they did with season 9, where Sharkface showed up for like one episode and became one of the big bad 3 villains of season 13.
I'm still annoyed at the way he went out.
That was so anticlimactic.
I saw it coming before he took off his helmet.
Oh, yeah, I mean, if he had at least charged at them and been, shot down or something, if he had charged at them instead of, screaming, "As long as I'm still alive, you're all as good as dead," and then the music just cuts and they're like, "Okay, shoot him." Bam. Like, if it had been one of those self-defense sort of moves where he's coming at them with, like, or, like, maybe say he had, like, some sort of personal bomb trigger thing on him.
Well, there's 2 ways they could have done it. If they would have launched a bullet in his skull before he finished his sentence, that would have been really funny. But the way they did it, it just didn't work.
As long as I'm alive, you're all as good as...
Yeah, that would have been funny.
Like I said, with Red vs. Blue Season 13, the scene with Locust inside of the portal, they actually had two versions for that. And this was in the commentary, which, yes, I watched because I'm that much of a Red vs. Blue nerd. They said that in the Red vs. Blue commentary with that episode, they had at least two options of how they were going to do it. We already know the one way they did it, where Locust was surrounded and everyone was calling him a monster. Yeah. Well, another version that they had, which I wish they would have at least made the scene and made it, you know, an alternate scene sort of deal, because that would have been absolutely terrific, is where there's a bunch of other Locusts in his old armor, you know, his old military armor, coming at him and trying to rip off his helmet to see what's underneath, a monster or a man. And I think that that would have been a great psychological one, but, I mean, the show isn't about psychological torture or anything like that. It's supposed to be about comedy. But Red vs. Blue has, you know, it's upped the sort of scale to entertainment that it's had. It's not just straight-up comedy anymore, and now it's got this intense drama, and we already know the church is gone. I think Season 14 will actually pick up where Season 13 left off, even though... Yeah.
It better. I still want that fight.
No, we're not going to get the fight, apparently.
There is one thing that happened there while they were recording Season 13 that I wish they would have just released on an alternate, on some sort of blooper or something, where they just had some problem with the... while they were recording, where Donut was just standing on the ground, and then he was dead because he had fallen to his death. Because I don't know how, I don't think they ever said it, but Donut had just been flung straight up into the air and then fell straight to his death. I don't know. I don't remember if they said how it happened.
I think that was probably, like, you know, a glitch or something.
Yeah, it was probably just a glitch, but...
I mean, because glitches happen in games all the time.
Yeah, but that could have been so much fun to just watch in anything. Even if it's just a short. They could have used that.
Right, there's a lot of, like, things in Red vs. Blue that... Think about how this podcast has gone. We've gone, like, so many different directions with every topic so far.
It's not even been an hour yet.
I know, but back to Red vs. Blue. Red vs. Blue has gone in so many different directions. And I think in Season 13, bringing back the whole, you know, the sword being a key thing... It's like, that was pretty good, especially with the revelation of, you know, Sister is still alive, Lopez didn't kill her after all. Griff called it and relocated. He's like, no. One time, she fell under the ice, and a few hours later, not only when we found her was she still alive, but she was pregnant. So, produce me a corpse, and then I'll believe you.
I want to go back and watch that season again.
I mean... On Netflix, they got, you know,
the first 12.
They got all 13 seasons, but they don't have like the mini series that sort of connect the other seasons together, like Relocated, Recovery 1, Out of Mind, you know, that kind of stuff. Which is too bad because they're good mini series, and I think Recovery 1 was a great way of introducing Wash, because it was really. I mean, they're all still on YouTube, so
yeah,
but I lost my train of thought with something.
We still haven't talked about Ruby much, have we?
No, we haven't. I think because Ruby has been over for about, what's it been, a month and a half?
I think it's been about two by now. I don't remember.
I think it did end in, like, mid-January. So, yeah, it's been, like, around 2 months.
Yeah.
Quite frankly, so it's been said that that woman at the end of Ruby was, that was Salem. I'm like, Salem? Salem what, Massachusetts? I know, bad joke, but I had to make it.
What I find interesting about that, the last few episodes, That was planned from before the show started. Before the first episode aired, that was planned. They pretty much wanted to skip season 2.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not surprised, because honestly, season 2 was great. Don't get me wrong. Season 2 was great, but not much happened in it regarding character development. I mean, we met Yang's mom and everything, but... And we heard a little bit more about Crow. We found out a little bit more about the White Fang. We met other characters. I mean, honestly, I think we spent more time, you know, introducing characters in season 2 than we did actually progressing the story.
Yeah. There was something about Crow. I think Crow also plays Tucker. I'd have to look into that, but
no,
I think
they are different voice actors. I would have known.
I can't remember.
I don't believe that Jason is playing Crow. I believe that's his name. Jason is the guy who plays Tucker.
They said the guy who played Crow's name, but I can't remember what it is.
Crow was a great addition to the show. So many people have been wondering, you know, who is Crow? What did he look like? What was his weapon? Honestly, we kind of got screwed over with Velvet in season 2 because they made this whole big deal about Velvet, what her powers would be, what her uniform would look like, what her semblance would be, and we didn't get it until the last 45 minutes of volume 3.
Yeah.
Which was it was a letdown, honestly, that we had to wait so long. But, I mean, when it showed up, don't get me wrong, you all saw my reaction, and I hope it was definitely, I freaked. We freaked, me and Ninja Storm 93.
I generally watch the episodes on my phone because my laptop sucks with it.
Oh, my laptop sucks, too. That's why I use... Actually, you can use your PlayStation 4 now.
Well, most of the time that I use it, half the time I want to just throw my phone just by my reaction.
Because of anger or shock or
more
insanity?
More just excitement. I think my phone's falling. I can see it in my hands. It's not moving, but I can no longer feel my phone.
Ruby... Pyrrha's death was... this season got so dark so quick. I mean, within 5 minutes of it, we got the full confirmation of John and Pyrrha, which I'll admit, I shipped that. And then 5 minutes later, bam, straight through the heart, arrow through Pyrrha's heart, and honestly... I'm kind of worried that she actually won't come back. I mean, we don't know how death works in the Ruby series entirely.
I actually have a friend that went, let's get a song to memorialize her death.
Memorialize?
Yeah. Yeah, you'd probably smack him if you knew what the song was.
Oh, what's the song?
It was a Bon Jovi. It's a Bon Jovi song. I don't know why I can say that. So.
What song?
Take a guess.
Shot through the heart and you're too lame. Oh, that's cruel. What?
My friends are idiots.
What? Who makes a joke like that? Someone's... Now because you've said that, I've got to make a Vine about that. I've got to get that clip of Pyrrha being shot in the chest. I'm going to have to get past the fact that my third favorite character gets shot in the chest. And I have to put that song clip over top of it.
I've been thinking about doing a review of the show, but the ending I would have to use that, and I'm not willing to do that.
Why?
Because I liked Pyrrha.
Oh yeah. It was there were people who actually did not ship Pyrrha and John, even though it was so obvious, and then now there's those people. Who they probably watch the episode and they're like, no, don't ship them together. No, ship them together. They don't belong together. Put John with Weiss or someone like that. And then they see Pyrrha die. They're like, yes! They're broken up! I'm like, oh, man. The John and Pyrrha haters are just there. They're going to be all over the place with this now.
Well, that goes with everyone.
Yeah. So we're getting close to the hour mark. So while we're on all sorts of different topics, the Teen Titans, Team Justice League versus Teen Titans, you said you've seen it. I haven't seen it yet. So it was a good movie.
Oh, yeah. I loved the movie.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I've heard a lot of good stuff about it. Like, is it as good as, you know, the other Batman movies we've been having with Damian Wayne lately?
Like I told you earlier, I only saw the first two. I just completely lost
the one. We're in the middle of a video. We'll be done in a few minutes.
But I need to go back and watch Bad Blood.
is Bad Blood the only one you haven't seen?
Yep.
I thought you...
The last one I watched was Batman versus Robin.
I didn't know you saw that.
I actually did a full reaction to the movie.
You did?
Yeah, I don't know where the file is anymore.
You didn't delete it, did you? I think I gotta see that reaction now.
Well, it was an audio one. So
it was an audio one?
Yeah.
So we don't actually see your actual face as you react to it.
Yeah, because that was after my computer had broken, so I didn't have the screen. So I couldn't do anything with that, and the camera never worked on that thing. So I wouldn't have been able to do it anyway.
Yeah. By the way, if you heard that name that was just called through the door, take a wild guess as to which one of us it was, because...
It wouldn't take long if they seen some of my videos, because Neon messes up sometimes.
Yeah. I've actually said what my name is in my very first video. As I explained, you know, my username, my YouTube channel name. Anyway, I think these movies, the Justice League movies and the new Batman movies, the animated ones, where they're all connected and they're all just done so well, they've kind of left a sort of mark. Like, there was Justice League War, then there's The Son of Batman, Justice League Throne of Atlantis, Batman versus Robin, then there's, like, so many others. Like, it's unbelievable sometimes.
Well, let me put it like this. Marvel needs to keep making live-action movies. DC needs to stop and start making more animated movies. That's how I'm going to put it.
It's sad, but I kind of agree a little bit. I mean, Batman vs. Superman was not a terrible movie. Yeah, I had so many problems with it, but it was nitpicking mostly. Just because, like I said, spoilers to those of you who haven't seen it yet, and I've already told you, but Batman does kill in the movie, and while it is criminals, it still kind of bugs me, because Batman has not done that since Michael Keaton days.
Yeah.
Well, actually, not Michael Keaton. Technically, Val Kilmer, technically Two-Face, was stupid enough to try to catch the coins and fell to his water grave because, you know, he decided, I must have the coin! I must have the... Ah! It's like, how stupid can you be? No coin is worth your life.
I'm sure there's a movie reference someone out there is going to put in the comments, but I can't think of it.
It was Batman Forever.
Not that. Something else.
I'm sure there is. Depending on if anyone is actually watching the video. What time are we at? We're at 2 minutes, so...
Oh,
we got like a minute left, so...
So, I actually started a DeviantArt page for my own thing. It's just Marcus Chronicle.
Oh, don't, dude. If you want to start publishing that stuff, you know, you can't just go throwing it around on, you know, DeviantArt. You know that, right?
It's just going to be more along the lines of just random art I'm not throwing up any big things like... pilots or anything. I'm not doing any of that.
Or any of the characters actually tailored to your own series.
Well, I do have to put up a few things for my own reasons, but that's all probably going to end up getting deleted in a few weeks anyway.
Anyway, we got about 30 seconds before this ends. So, I've been Kendrick. This has been Marcus Chronicle from Greystone Chronicles. Be sure to check out his channel. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. be sure to hit that like button and smash that subscribe button. As always, share this with as many people as you can. We greatly appreciate it. We're going to try to make this a more regular thing, maybe weekly or bi-weekly. We'll see how it goes. I've been Kendrick, she's been Marcus. Have an awesome day, people. Peace out. And, you know, leave us in the comment section below. What do you want us to talk about in a future podcast? We'll catch you all later. Peace.